The charred remains of Nuke London are the backdrop for MFL action at Flumbly Stadium, which proved again today why it's the cheating capital of the league by towing every car in the parking lot to the team-owned impound next door. Today's matchup is going to be a good one. The teams take the field. The Midway Mutants battle the Nuked London Hatriots. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say.
Yo, man, nobody can touch me an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. What you talking about?
If you like your cocktail cold, your soup hot, and your steak still mooing, then you're going to love seeing mutants knocked cold, their brains turned into hot lava soup, and their bodies strewn about the field, lying still and barely moving. MFL Game Day is on the air.
You just made me hungry, Ben. I'm going to go get some extra crispy mutant finger strips.
Hey, get me a full slab of broken mutant ribs while you're there.
And it's first and 10.
Hot.
He picks up 8 yards on that pass. Second down and two.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Well, he just heard footsteps and took his eye off the ball.
What a peck ahead. Catch the ball, asshole. Hey, asshole up here. Talking to you.
Hot. Hot one, hot two, hot.
Whoa, and he laterals the ball. And that'll give him 4 more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's first and 10.
Hot.
Second down and ain't gonna happen, hot, partner.
Hot one, hot two. Hot.
And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit. Hot one, hot two.
Shower of blood and guts.
And the pieces of him are flying into the cheap seats.
See that move, baby? I'm the greatest. No, you didn't see that because I'm too fast.
Is this deja vu?
This is like our bazillionth season, dumbass.
Actually, I think he's talking about the time warp dirty trick that the defense just played. Still a dumbass, though. That's a 4-yard gain. Second down and 6.
Hot one, hot two.
One in for a first down to keep the drive alive. First down and one.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two. Hot. Hot.
Oh, man, what a... And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown.
I would have thought you had to have muscles to move like that.
Nor a brain or a nervous system, but I see your point, Rick. Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. straight through the uprights. The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. And it's first and ten.
What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and two. First down! And this guy is a stud, Bricks.
You're telling me! Nice run!
No, I mean, he's a real stud. He works at the Mutant Stud Farm weekends and summers. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yowling.
Third down and six. To play with soft balls, he's gonna play with crushed balls from here on out. Boring, but smart. Time to punt.
Whoa, whoa, you can't say that on the radio.
And he booted a high arcing rainbow. He's got the ball now and is gonna try and score. Cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. He's at the 30. He's at the 20. He's at the 10. And that was a game-breaking punt return for a touchdown. And if you don't understand why refs are hated even more than kickers, well, there's your answer, Bricks. Looks like it's a jailbreak, and the defense jumps offside to kill the ref. Ho-ho! Crowd's loving it.
Yeah.
And it's first and ten. Looks like the defense called the ginormous dirty trick. It's about a 3-yard pickup. Second down and seven. Oh, and that one's gonna hurt. He may not be able to comprehend math after that hit.
What's math?
Exactly. And it's first and ten. And he gets 3 yards on that run. Second down and seven. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. The kick is good!
And
wasn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. The teams are all tied up at the end of quarter one. We'll be right back. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
Second down and nine.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
I don't know if he even had a target on that throw. Third down and nine.
Hot one, hot two.
And he rumbles for nine on that play. You know, sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back. Well, that's a lovely shank for the punter today. He just put his team in the hole. Nicely, they let the punt drop, and it will be down by the defense. And it's first and ten.
Much like my wedding night, there was a big explosion, but then everyone left disappointed.
Everyone? You had more than two people in the room?
Yeah, the guy filming the clown. Somebody's got to make the balloon animals.
And he runs it for 4 yards. Third down and six. And the quarterback throws a murder ball, which will slice its way through any defensive player trying to block it. Gets the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and ten. Second down and a lot. And then it's a first down from a great catch.
Was it a catch, though? Let's consult at least 72 pages of rules to figure it out.
And it's first and ten. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven-baked portage on in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
And that'll bring up second and one. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
First down. And it's first and ten. Was just starting to pick up some speed.
Hey, Grim, I know a guy if that's what you're after.
Second down and six. And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown! Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one.
Well, fee, fi, fo, fum.
I'm not finishing that joke, Grim. The only low.
First down. He was not going to drop that one. They need to make him a target more often. Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Running into a buzzsaw, Bricks.
Okay, he just ran into a buzzsaw.
They've got one more timeout left, but they've stopped the clock.
Why don't they just take the batteries out of the clock, Grim? That would make more sense.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks.
And timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Just keep pounding the ball right up the gut, and you'll tire these guys out. First down. The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Oh, that'll trim your nostril hairs once and for all. And here comes the extra point attempt. It's good. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. Pickup of about three on that play. The kicker just ended up in the meat wagon. They'll need to find another player on their bench who can kick field goals. Good luck with that. This is going to be a long kick. Let's see if he can make it. Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from top.
It appears that the ref just received a pair of very expensive alligator skin shoes. They need to put some cement shoes on before this game slips away.
I always wanted a pair of alligator skin shoes, Grim. I heard though when you put them on, they feel just like chicken skin shoes.
And And this is a first and offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. First down and forever. It was a risky throw and the defense made him pay. Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. It's a tie game at the end of quarter two. The teams are deadlocked in a fierce struggle today. We'll be right back with today's halftime show brought to you by Monsatan Industries. Eat their delicious Frankenfood.
Hey, throw in the half. Can you pick me up a Soylent beer?
The teams line up for the second half kickoff, deadlocked in a tie game. Briggs, there is nothing worse than a tie game.
I'm going to disagree. I'm going to say entire iron in your face.
Well, that's a good point. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Cut to avoid the saw, but the saw just made a better, cleaner cut to the ball carrier. Second down and five. I'm gonna say maybe 3 yards, but a tough 3 yards. Third and two. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. And it's first and ten. And that's how you run the football. A pickup of 7 on the play.
Why is it that more mentally disturbed clowns don't play football? They'd be good.
Yeah, they're all in politics, apparently. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is all about momentum and killing. And it's first and 10. Play by the defense. It's not too often a quarterback gets rejected.
That's why that's the position I originally tried out for. I want to know what it's like for other people to accept you.
Now that went from a joke to making me feel feelings. Stop it. This isn't a place to feel feelings. This is football. They go to the ground game and pick up the first. Nicely done. And it's first and 10. Defense has the receivers covered well. That's a 3 yard gain on that pass. Second down and 7. Third down and, well, good luck. Maybe the QB should throw it and catch it, too. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
That's bleak, Bricks. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
They need a good return here to set up the offense. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And it's first and ten. And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down in a mile. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. Second down and more than the QB would like.
One, hot two. Hot.
Talk about butterfingers. He should have had that one. Third down and long.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
And that is called for a first down. And it's first and ten. And he picked up a lot of real estate in a hurry. Give him 10 yards right there. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
Third down and a sliver.
Hot. Hot one. Eight.
Man, guys, like a freight train. Nice pickup there for a first down. And it's first and ten.
Hot. Hot one. Hot two.
Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them.
Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Their marketing team hates it.
And it's first and ten. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and three. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Thank you.
Second down in a very lot. Quarter three comes to an end, but this game is far from over and will be decided in the final quarter. Second down and more than the QB would like. You've got to catch that. Third down and the punter is warming up. Whenever a player gets big like this, it reminds me that, man, he just laid the wood on him on that one and knocked the ball out. And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. And that'll bring up second and one.
Hot one, hot two, eight.
First down! I see this guy drop a lot of balls in the past, but I heard the quarterback threaten to throw him a real bomb if he dropped one again. You know, good communication is important.
Hot one, hot two, hot eight.
If you don't hear it coming, and that was a perfect pass, and he scores handily. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sinners then.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
First and ten. Oh, with the brutal hit. And that'll bring up second and one. And the ball razors through the defense, cutting a defender in half. And it's first and ten. Oh, with the brutal hit. Second down in a very lot. Bricks, they're going for two here. And he runs it in for an easy 2 points. The momentum in this game may be shifting.
Oh, those are just my balls.
Hey, thanks for sharing, Bricks.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah,
first and 10. And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and 3. First and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot.
Anyone in the mood for a mutant tartar? You know, a lot of guys talk about stepping up their game, Bricks. He just stepped up and blew up. He's got a lot of guts, doesn't he? And you can see the grounds crew cleaning him up now. Hot potato gets him every time. Second down and 2. Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He sets up for the return. Let's see if he can break one wide open. First and 10.
Something went very wrong with that. Bombs away.
What was your first hit? The lack of blood? Everyone having all their limbs? He's an idiot.
Second down and 10. Ouch! Anyone in the mood for a steak tartare? Two-minute warning sounds. They'll have to regroup during this timeout. And it's first and 10. He had it for a second there. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Same as Bridge's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit shit. I took it as a cop.
And there's an 8-yard catch.
Chipping away with those medium passes. I like it. Like a patient.
They stump the clock with their first timeout, leaving them with 2 in case they need them.
Yeah, just like condoms, hatchets, and wives, huh, Grim?
You know, you just summed up why we don't get together outside of work, Bricks.
Caught for a first down. And it's for a timeout is called by the quarterback. They have 1 left. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And then catch will give them a first down. And they are out of timeout. The clock just became their greatest enemy.
Really? The clock? The clock, Grim? I can smash a clock. That's not a great enemy.
We're not talking about waking up at the crack of noon. We're talking about the MFL, you moron.
Quarterback passes for a touchdown. It's a time warp dirty trick. The last play is erased. How did they do that?
Did they go 88 miles per hour? Just asking.
He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. And he catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play!
Yeah, it's almost poetic, Green, like a haiku!
They want more points, so they're going for two. Stops him cold. That play just got blown to hell.
Yeah, it got blown to shit.
They'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. And it's first and ten. Too many players that kids can look up to at home. Oh, and that's what it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made at the dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
The Hatriots put the heat on their opposition and are the victors today. That was one hell of a slugfest. That was worth the price of admission, right, guys?
When I paid for admission, I expect girls dancing on a pole or something.
Girls, win. I want a lap dance.
You don't even have a lap, you little freakazoid.
Follow me.
Let's see what the MVP has to say about today's outcome. Once again, the folks at Evil Assan thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's final game stats are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every up.